Aggies have ever gone before. NASA has selected a UC Davis health nurse for a year-long experiment, and she is one of only just four people who have been chosen for this mission so far. Thanks for joining us. For Fox 40 News at 5:30, I'm Eric Harriman.
And I'm Nikki Lorenzo. They live in a closed habitat for 365 days to simulate life on Mars. Fox 40's Zach Boeto joining us now in studio after speaking with that nurse about how she will play a role in the future of space exploration. Zach?
Well, Nikki, NASA has created this 3D printed living space in Houston, and Alyssa Shannon was one of four people selected to live in it for a year to figure out how they'll survive in the harsh Mars-like conditions. Alyssa says she's wanted to do something like this since she was a kid, and now she's getting to live out her dream.
The mission to get humans to Mars is getting much closer to becoming reality, and a new NASA mission is giving one UC Davis health nurse the chance to etch her name in space exploration history.
It's just been wonderful to work with NASA. I never thought my career would go in this direction, and in a few weeks now I'm going to be going to the Johnson Space Center.
NASA selected four people, including Alyssa Shannon of UC Davis Health, to participate in its series of missions known as Crew Health and Performance Exploration Analog, or CHAPEA, with hopes of learning how they respond under the rigor of a long-duration, ground-based simulation in a 3D-printed habitat called Mars Dune Alpha.
The mission is a Mars simulation so that NASA will gain information about resource trades to help future missions on Mars be more successful. This will involve challenges for humans such as resource limitations, time delay communication, and many other challenges.
Alyssa has backpacked around the world, and she believes her experiences will provide her with some valuable insight when going into the minimalist habitat and surviving with little for an extended period of time. But one of her biggest hurdles, she says, will be living away from family and her home state.
It's definitely challenging. I've been trying to spend a lot of time outside, appreciating nature, knowing that I'm going to go without seeing California wildflowers for a season. But the bigger mission, though, is getting to provide this invaluable research. Yeah. And I think that's even more important than giving up some day-to-day comforts.
Alyssa says the bigger picture of human existence and support from her family are what's giving her the courage to go through with it all.
It means a huge deal to be able to help and to know that when 10, 15, however many years, when we finally do land on Mars, I'll have played a small role in helping us get there.
And for the little kids who think they might want to go to Mars or work with NASA one day, she leaves them with this.
I would say be curious, stay engaged with the world, and believe in yourself, because when you have faith in yourself, you can overcome many hurdles.
Alyssa says she leaves for the Johnson Space Center in Houston in a few weeks for training, and that mission is expected to kick off in June. Of course, Nikki, Eric, we are all wishing her luck.
Wishing her luck, Zach, and I can't wait to get the second half of that interview, 366 days from the time that she embarks on it. What a mission.
We're going to have to do that follow-up for sure. I'll reach out. Next June.
Looking forward to it. Zach, thank you.